Hey guys, and welcome to the BHCS News Desk. I'm Captain Awesome. Today I am joined by Melody Messenger, who is 2021 school captain, and Sam Davis, who once I think captained his under-11 soccer team.
Thanks, Mr. Booth. It's great to have you on board also. Hello everyone, and welcome to our telecast of the BHCS 2021 celebration.
We've got a jam-packed program for you, covering all the highlights of the 2021 year.
Sure has been a doozy, hasn't it, guys?
Well, Mr. Booth, it sure wasn't what we were expecting, but that's for sure. But I know one thing about BHCS, and that's... We are champions!
We are the champions, my friends! Everybody now! We'll keep on...
Yeah, cut that. Post-edit, cut that, please. Thanks, Mr. Booth, but that was horrible. So, we are champions at getting through hard times and making the most out of the experience.
I couldn't have said it better myself, Sam. Now let's take a sneak peek at just some of what we've got in store for you.
Great idea, Melody. We'll be heading to the Largeton Middle School Olympics and catching up with some of our seasoned athletes.
Our talented junior students will be treating a special song to us.
And have we got a time machine in here or something? It says in my program that the senior school students are going to be meeting up with Ernest Shackleton. Now, that was from the Endurance. I think that was back in 1914 or something.
I guess we're going to find out. There's plenty more in store for you tonight. But for now, sit back, relax,
and get some snacks.
Into what it was like to be a kinder student this year.
Are you Kirsty?
Wow, what a year it has been. We've been in lockdown, we've been out of lockdown, we've been in lockdown, we've been out of lockdown, and throughout it all, kinder has remained open. It has been so wonderful to see all the families and the children connect with each other, whether they be online or off-site. It's been amazing the amount of things that we've managed to pack in during COVID restrictions when we could. We've been able to have firefighters come and visit, police officers come and visit. We even got to go on an excursion on a train. It was so awesome. But as we start to think towards the school holidays, I pray for us all. I pray that we manage to connect with family and friends. We get to go on holidays. We get to go to the beach and that we stay healthy and well. And that most of all, we have fun. Here's a little snippet of what we got up to this year.
Change the world. home. I wanna be somebody to someone. And if the sun starts setting, the sky goes cold, and if the clouds get heavy and start to fall, I really need somebody to call my own. I wanna be somebody to someone. Someone to you. Someone to you. Someone to you.
Hey,
Sam, guess what? What do you want for Christmas under there?
What underwear?
Sam wants underwear for Christmas, guys. Oh, what were you saying?
You could say that our school theme, the strength to endure, was pretty much the perfect line to sum up what we all had to get through.
It's almost like someone knew what was going on. Is there a time machine around here somewhere?
Well, I'm not sure about that, but I can see a few storm clouds brewing behind us.
It looks like we're in for a bit of a wild ride.
Oh, the wind's picking up. I think this would be the perfect time for me to try and test out this HPV.
Mr. Booth, I don't think we've got the time for that.
Mr. Booth, I don't think that's a wise idea.
I reckon with this wind, I could set a new land speed record.
Anyway, let's cross to our middle school students as they compete in the Olympics.
We've got our captains standing by, Oscar, Georgia, Grace and Harry. What's going on where you are?
This year has really tested us. We found it difficult to stay motivated in our learning and we struggled to stay connected to others.
But something happened in late July that helped take our eyes off our own circumstances. The Olympics. Australia placed 6th on the world stage and we were so proud to see the amazing efforts of those men and women who represented our country.
Each person competing, whether they came first, last or anywhere in between, was an inspiration for all of us, as we could relate to the concept of persevering in the attempt to succeed.
We now cross live to our sports correspondent, Bryce McInavey.
Thank you. And we are joined here in the final week of the Olympics with a few incredible athletes as we witness history in the making. All right, now we cross to the 400 metre hurdles, and they're off. Sarah Carley representing Australia in lane 5. Placing 5th, not enough to finish in the quarterfinals, but gee, she put in a top effort. Here she comes to have a chat. Sarah, how'd you think you went?
Oh gosh, well, I guess most people in life avoid hurdles, but I run straight for them. It doesn't always turn out the way you hope, but I find that if you keep on turning up and trying your best to face those hard things, in the end you can always be satisfied that you ran a good race.
A philosopher and an athlete. Well done, Sarah. Now, we turn our attention back to the course, where Liam Adams has put in an amazing effort, only over 42.2 kilometres, under a time of 2 hours, 51 minutes and 29 seconds. Liam, a mammoth task here. What did you learn from your experience?
I can just catch my breath.
Sure, yeah.
Whew. Sometimes you really don't think you're going to make it. There's always a point around the halfway mark where it just feels like too much, like I'll never be able to cross that finish line. But I try not to think about too much of the distance left and just keep putting one foot in front of the other. And somehow, here we are. This feeling, the exhilaration and the satisfaction of finishing the race, it never gets old.
Way to go, Liam. Go enjoy your long rest. You've earned it. Now, We head to the basketball court where the girls have won against Slovenia with a score of 103-97. That means the girls will take home bronze for Australia. And some of the girls have come to have a chat. Yeah! Girls, what a game!
It was a big one, eh?
Yeah, I was the best on the court for sure.
It was a team effort, though.
I know. To be honest, we couldn't have done it without each other, even if I was the main star.
Well, I reckon that celebrating as a team is much better than celebrating alone. Can I say hi to someone?
Sure, yeah.
Hi, Mum. Hi, Dad. Thanks for taking me to all my basketball practice and all the games.
How touching. Thanks, girls. We'll see you back on the court soon. And there we have it, folks. We've seen some incredible examples of courage, endurance, and teamwork here today. Whatever your situation, may you too throw off anything that faces your way, and you may see the great cloud of witness cheering you on to succeed. Until next time, stay strong and be brave.
The school council is the group of parents and other friends of the school who have the overall responsibility for our school, make very, very important decisions. And today we want to honour the chair, the person in charge of that group of people, Dirk Jackson, who has stepped down from his position after many years of service. This is what was said about Dirk. Dirk has served as a member of the school council for 26 years, the past five as chair. He has maintained an unwavering commitment to the place of faith in God and in his son Jesus Christ as the ground on which we must stand in all our dealings on behalf of the families for whom the school exists. Dirk, who recently announced his decision to retire from the council, has sacrificed a great deal of his time and energy to ensure that the school's extraordinary development has proceeded on sound lines and with due consideration for all stakeholders. His patient negotiations with the local church regarding the purchase of the land, which will enable further development of the school's excellent facilities, are a testimony to his commitment to the school's welfare. Dirk has never been a parent at the school, and apart from the early years, has lived at a considerable distance from it. He has clearly had a firm conviction that Christian schools are a wonderful means of demonstrating God's love to the community. As a school council, we wish to acknowledge Dirk's great contribution and to thank him for it. For sticking with us through thick and thin, we say thank you, Dirk. And God bless you as you follow his further calling on your life. We will miss your familiar presence around BHCS. You never missed an important event, including every celebration night. Well done. Thank you, Dirk.
Being a school captain is a huge privilege.
It sure is, and a great responsibility.
Getting to be a representative and a leader of your community really impacts you in a profound way.
We're really excited to introduce the school captains and leaders for the next year and see how they make the role their own and take on the responsibility of leadership.
Starting with our junior school, we're excited to announce the vice captains for 2022, Grace Hargraves and Chris Agrimito.
And the captains of junior school will be Josiah Arnold and Harley Denny.
Congratulations to all of you. I'm sure our junior school will be in safe hands.
And for our middle school, we are pleased to announce the student leaders and captains for the year of 2022.
They are Kayla Anchin, Imogen Corrales, Kira Laurie, Harrison McKenzie, and Samson Kahinga.
Congratulations to you all. You're in for a fun year ahead.
Moving on to our senior school, in 2022 we will have five student leaders and two school captains.
Our student leaders will be Josiah Barker, Will Darra, Isaac Seskis, Charlotte Valla, and Sasha Whitaker.
And our captains for 2022 will be Kiana Vellon and Taya Desta. Congratulations to all of you. We officially pass the mantle over to you and wish you all the best. We would love to pray for you as you take on your new role.
Let's pray. God, we lift up these amazing leaders to you. We pray that you would bless them for their willingness to stand up and be counted. As you have sustained us this year, we pray that you would also be their guide and lead this group of new leaders in your wisdom. We thank you for your grace this year and your provision of strength to get us through some pretty big challenges. And we ask that you give these new leaders the faith to serve the incredible BHCS community in 2022. Amen.
What an epic performance. Thanks, Bryce, for your coverage. It's really interesting to reflect on what endurance looks like and how many great examples we can draw from.
And congratulations to our 2022 school captains as well.
I wonder how many people out there set the record of consecutive days wearing their PJs this year.
At least on the lower half. Well, that weather behind us looks like it's beginning to shift a little bit. It isn't going to hail, is it?
In Victoria, I wouldn't be surprised anymore. After epic storms and power blackouts, that earthquake!
Oh, hang on, guys. It's all right. Got my trusty generator here. We'll be able to have power back in no time. I should have bought shares in generators this year. Would have made an absolute fortune. Here we go, guys!
Starting summer with a 30-degree day that ended in flash floods.
Good point. While we still have our feed, let's cross to the junior school and see what they've learnt this year.
In ye olden days, when knights were bold and kings and queens wore crowns of gold.
Strength was found in sword and shield, the victor reigned, the vanquished yield.
Might was right and strength was king, the strong could do most anything.
Or so they thought in armour strong, but one lone voice could prove them wrong.
God is our refuge and our strength, a very present help in trouble.
Trouble? Did somebody say trouble?
Oh no, it's surprise!
Harold!
Who's Harold?
My Harold.
He's Harold.
My Harold. Actually, he's just filling in for my usual Harold. Harold is my Harold's son.
Harold's son? The Harold's son?
No, yes, but no. He's Harold the Herald.
Oh, Harold the
Hear ye, lords and ladies, dukes and duchesses, nobles and niblets. May I present the mighty nighty and tidy whitey surprise.
Just when you don't expect me, here I am. Surprise! Sorry, didn't mean to scare you.
You, sir, couldn't even scare yourself out of your wits, because you are already witless. Mwahaha!
Ah, my arch nemesis, Surcharge, still taking more credit than what I earned, I see.
Ooh. Call me greedy, but I can see that your lockdown is not being kind to you. Perhaps you should change your name to Circumference.
Ooh. How dare you?
How dare you?
I challenge you to a duel, sir, or should we just change your name to Surrender?
Take that!
Ha!
And that!
Ha!
Take that!
Ha!
And that!
Ha!
I don't mean to blow trumpet, but even I can see that fighting like this isn't going to get you anywhere. Being the strongest doesn't make you right.
Well, what do you suggest we do?
Be strong in the Lord, put on the full armour of God so that you may be able to stand your ground.
With the belt of truth buckled around your waist.
With the breastplate of righteousness protecting your heart.
With your feet fitted for the gospel of peace.
Peace? But we are knights.
It's our job to fight.
No, it's your job to be ready to fight. It's your job to defend.
So stand firm.
With the strength to endure.
Take up the shield of faith.
Take up the shield of salvation.
Take up the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God.
Hit it, Mr. Minstrel!
Put on the armor of God.
Armor of God.
We have the strength to endure.
Strength to endure.
Put on the armor of God.
Armor of God.
We have the strength to endure.
Strength to endure.
Take truth for a belt. Breastplate of righteousness. Take shoes made of peace. And faith. Put on the armor of God.
Armor of God.
We have the strength to endure.
Strength to endure.
Put on the armor of God.
Armor of God.
We have the strength to endure.
Strength to endure. Yeah.
Concert, remember?
Oh, sorry.
God is faithful, don't be anxious, be strong in the Lord. We can do all things through Christ who strengthens us.
Every year we honour our students for their outstanding academic achievements. Literally last week, hundreds of our students achieved special certificates at the Awards Assembly, and we congratulate every one of them. Today I'm joined by Mr. Callow, Mrs. Frangi, as we acknowledge the efforts of four outstanding Year 12 graduates.
It's my pleasure to present the Emerging Leader Award for 2021. This recipient has demonstrated significant potential as a leader, serves willingly, demonstrates faith in action, and has impressive people skills. Congratulations, Will Devers.
Thank you.
Well done.
The AMPOL Best All-Rounder Award goes to Jonathan Ferrand, and that's for recognition of the students' excellence in academic, leadership, sporting and community service activities. Well done, Jonathan. Congratulations.
Thank you.
This year I have the pleasure of presenting two Principal's Awards for outstanding service, dedication, leadership and exemplary role modelling. Firstly, to Liam Hibbins. Well done, Liam.
Thank you.
And Grace Hoban. Thank you, Grace. Congratulations, and thank you to both of you for all you've done for our school.
Every year we pay special tribute to the Ducks of the previous year. The Ducks is just a special way of saying that student which achieved the highest ATAR award. This award will be presented by Mr. Callow.
And last year, 2020 Ducks of our school, highest performing academic student, is a great pleasure, Annabelle Cock. Thank you.
Thank you.
And Annabelle. And we've got a really nice present for you. It's
wow.
iPad. So there you go. Enjoy. And Annabelle, I believe you're studying at University of Melbourne.
Yes.
English and linguistics.
Yes, that's
right. Where's that pathway going to take you, do you
think? It's a good question. At the moment, I'm really hoping to get into publishing, but I know it's a very limited industry in Australia. But that's the fingers crossed what I'm hoping to head into, but I'll probably have to do a master's first.
A master's and then possibly overseas travel?
And possibly overseas travel, yeah. I'm thinking of possibly going and doing my master's in the UK if I get in, which hopefully I will.
Well, we wish you every blessing and every success.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
For senior school, this has been a particularly challenging year.
It sure has. We've really had to motivate ourselves to get our schoolwork done on time, and it hasn't been easy missing out on many of the milestones we've looked forward to for so long.
Endurance has been a very accurate term for what we've needed this year. And there was another endurance, an endurance captained by Ernest Shackleton, that really puts things into perspective as we manage the ups and the downs of lockdown this year.
Let's see if these guys can learn from the past and figure out what they need in time.
Attempt 58, is this
thing
gonna work,
Helen? We're so close. I need this gear so bad. This time we've got it. Come on.
That's what you said the last 50 times.
It would be better if Bingo didn't keep dying.
Hey, it's not easy keeping you guys alive.
Well, if you don't get it this time, I'm out.
Hey, guys, what's that glowing button over there?
Ignore it, Grace. Just keep attacking the boss.
What if it's a part of the game? Callum, what if it's the reason we keep losing?
That's it. I'm pressing it.
No! Don't!
What the?
Where are we?
It's freezing.
What the dickens have we here? What? What outfits?
Speak for yourself.
Yeah, well, at least we're warm.
You've got a point. Wait, I know who you guys are. We learned about you in history. Aren't you Ernest Shackleton and Frank Worsley? Who? From the Endurance? The ship that got stuck in the ice and the men got stranded for a year and a half?
No way.
I don't remember that story. Those poor dogs.
Yeah, but 22 of the men actually survived from below freezing temperatures with hardly any food and made it home. I can't imagine you surviving more than a week without your hairdryer, Sarah.
Huh, how about you without your gaming?
I once went 2 whole days without gaming. I never want to do that again.
So, you're experiencing a problem.
Yes, we're trying to get through to the final boss battle, and we need some gear really bad.
Are these actual garments you speak of?
I wish.
No, it's virtual. Like invisible?
You require invisible clothing.
Gross.
It's really not hard to know how to find solutions to these modern problems. But in my experience, just when things look their worst, they turn out for the best.
I've often marveled at the thin line that divides success from failure and how a sudden turn can change certain disaster to safety.
So you mean to say when things look really bad, it might turn out okay if we just keep trying?
Sometimes you just need to hold on. As Ernest says, difficulties are just things to overcome. That's all.
Hey guys, I think I know what I'm missing. I'll cover you.
Nice one, Bingo. Thanks for the heal.
You're so close!
Yes!
Thank goodness that's over.
Come on, let's see the drop. Hey, the Shackleton tunic of endurance looks epic. and feels really familiar for some reason.
That wasn't real, was it?
Well, whatever it was, I'm just glad that we don't have to do that battle again.
Now, there's one more piece of gear that I...
No!
Will we never that strange, Frank?
Oh, I highly doubt it, sir.
What's for dinner? It better not be Bernard. I love Bernard.
Oh, we'll see. We'll talk about it again.
It's interesting when you look back on examples from history, like the endurance, how resilient humans can be.
Yeah, even when playing games.
One person who's been an incredible example of humility, hard work, generosity and service is our esteemed principal, Andy Keller. We appreciate all the time and work you've put into our school community to make it what it is today, and the example you are to all of us.
Maybe you could tell us what these clouds are behind me now. I don't know clouds very well, guys, but I know that Mr. Andy Callow does. I think there's some cloud called a cumulonimbus. Actually, funny story, guys. My auntie once had a car
okay, Mr.
called
Booth,
a nimbus.
That's enough.
We fit 17
Let's get
people.
Let's do something worth listening to.
Okay.
It'll be such an honour to hear Mr. Callow's last ever official message as principal to the BHCS community. But before we hear from him, let's cross to Mr. Davidson with a special farewell.
It's my privilege tonight to say a few special words as a farewell to Mr. Callow. Can I also warmly welcome you, Daphne, with us this evening too. There once was a young man named Andrew. He arrived at a school where staff were few. He rolled up his sleeves, even cleaned out the eaves. And now he proudly hands over a school that looks brand new. You've always been willing to get your hands dirty, to lead by example, and never to ask someone to do something you were not willing to do. Planting trees, serving coffees, or doing bus duty. You've helped to transform BHCS physically, and it looks a much better place because of all that you've done. There once was a man named Andy, who with chalk, speech, or chainsaw was quite handy. His passion was teaching, his effect on all far-reaching, and now he proudly hands over a school much sweeter than candy. Your passion for teaching and working with children has never wavered, and there won't be many students or staff that won't forget what you have taught them about clouds or the water cycle. And no one will forget the times you've joined the students in the pool at swimming carnival days. You've helped to transform how teachers teach and interact with students. There once was an old man named Callow, whose leadership you definitely could never call shallow. His desire was to honour God, and to that we can all give a nod. And now he proudly hands over a school where our faith undoubtedly did grow. Your faith in God has been what has driven you and how you've led. You've been faithful in sharing the gospel and sharing stories of how your life has been changed by knowing him. You've helped to transform this school spiritually. On behalf of the school community, staff, students, parents, friends, I want to say a massive thank you. Thank you for many years of faithful service leading a school that has become known for its generosity, its fun, its willingness to embrace anyone and everyone, and as a place where lives are being changed for the better. Thank you. We'll miss you. May God bless you and Daphne in the next chapter of your lives. We're now just going to hear from a few others who are going to say a few words of thanks as well.
G'day, Andy. Thank you for your generosity, your mateship, and just willingness to have a laugh about so many of the things that happen in life. What I'm going to miss the most is your willingness and readiness to talk about anything to do with the weather and clouds and geography. I am going to miss that. Cheers, mate.
Oh, will I miss the most about Andy? I think it's got to be the dad jokes. Sometimes I just love them and sometimes Oh my gosh. I really want to say thank you for taking a chance on me all those many years ago for employment at the school. It's just been the best time. And it's just not going to be the same without you because you're not going to be here anymore. It's just, yeah.
Oh, Andy. That is your name, isn't it? Yeah, that's right. Yeah, look, I'm really going to miss you. You've been the best principal I've ever worked for. Is it the only principal? No, there have been others too, but really, I'm going to miss your laughter and the fun we've had with you.
Okay, there's about a billion things I could say, but my most memorable moment with you, Andy, is when you actually took me down to the creek to film that goat or take a photo of that goat on the island and my shoe got stuck and got sucked off. So that'll be my favourite moment. I just want to thank you for being my mentor, for helping me grow into the person I am today. I couldn't have done it without you and I'm going to so miss you.
Thank you for your heart and your character, for always believing in us, for fighting for us, for choosing to see the good and to really work for our transformation and redemption. I believe with all my heart that a mustard seed has been planted in our school that will continue to grow and to be a shining light for what the future of Christian education might be.
So what am I going to miss about Andy Callow? So many things. Kind of like having a boss who's also a father figure. You know, hearing that laugh coming out of your office, I'll definitely miss that. And just, you know, your wise and kind words.
Andy, I'm so grateful for your caring presence, for your missional heart, for the way that you enable your staff to succeed and to thrive. So many great memories of you interacting with your students in the car park, in the swimming pool. Thank you so much for the legacy that you've left in each of us.
Dear Andy, well, I'm just so grateful for the way that you have over so many years sought to model out the vitality that comes from living life with Christ. And then the way you've sought to create an environment at BHCS where all our students and staff and our parents have had a chance to experience that vitality too. Long may that legacy endure.
So Andy, there are very many things that I'm going to miss about you. Not least of all your humour. And very secretly, I find it funnier than I probably make out. I am going to miss your puns. I'm going to miss your dad jokes. And I thank you for the leadership and the example that you've set for me this year and many years before as well. Go well and enjoy your entire retirement.
Cheers, mate.
See you soon.
All the best. See you later.
See ya.
Peace and hope.
Bye.
See you around.
Farewell.
And we've just got a few flowers here that we'd like to hand over to you. And I'd love to pray for you just as I finish up here. So let me pray for you both. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for Andy. Thank you also for the great support he's had from so many, from Daphne, from his family, from staff and students here. We thank you for all that he's done for this school under your hand. We thank you that each step along the way he's wanted to acknowledge you as the one who has provided and led him as he's sought to honour you and sought to lift your name up in this place. Pray that you'd continue to guide him as he moves on to something new next year. Pray, Lord, that you continue to bless him and the impact that he'll have on the people that he spends time with moving on from this place. We again just say a big thank you for all that he's done, and we pray a special blessing upon Andy and Daphne in the next chapter of their lives. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you. One of the students asked me a really interesting question the other day. They said, "What's your favourite location at BHCS?" The response was instant. Thanks, Steve. The restaurant. And then I thought through why. And I thought, there's so many good things happen in this space. For a start, staff devotions every morning. That's one of the things I'm going to really miss at the school, is the richness and the power of each person in turn sharing what something of meaning to them and challenge us to be better teachers and people. Yeah, staff devotions every morning in here. That's a start. And then there's music and so much laughter and singing together. And then there's all the meetings in here, the official meetings, like with what it be for the new prep parents, right through to your senior students, careers nights and all sorts of things. So many good meetings happen in this space. Then there's all the welcome celebrations. I mean, we start the year off in here with a huge staff breakfast. That's always a lot of fun. And welcome all the new staff at that time. And we also welcome new parents with a new parents dinner. We welcome all sorts of people here, politicians and other principals. We have principals meetings in here. But the best parts are probably not so much the formal meetings, but the one-on-one coffees with people and the conversations that can be very serious and sometimes hilarious. And it's the fellowship over food and drink that is so Belgrave. It, I love about this school that we're into hospitality and generosity. We also have farewells, bittersweet as they are here, at the end of the year when we're farewelling people and speeches and tears and laughter again. So many memories of this space. One of my most memorable conversations happened just over here with a guy called Paul Campy. Now, Paul's an incredibly experienced consultant who works in hundreds and hundreds of Australian schools and many overseas schools, basically running the ruler over the school. And we invited him to spend many days here in just case studies and talking to teachers and staff and looking at all our documentation. It was very intense. And right at the end of it, he said, can we meet up for coffee? So, of course, we met here. And he leaned forward and he said, I've told the Year 12s a story. He leaned forward and he said, I can describe BHCS in one word. Well, he had my attention. And I leaned forward and he said, redemption. To buy back. To give a second chance. And then he just reflected on the stories of staff and students and even parents whose lives have been changed for good by this community and have come to faith and discovered God in this place. And I nearly cried. It was probably the best word he could have used and the most incredible encouragement to me in my job here. It's been a great privilege to work at this school. Great privilege. The students, so many of you, the parents and families, and I think most vividly to me and my colleagues here, the people who've travelled the journey with me for many years, who've been loyal, supportive, at times good, critical friends, as a security in that. And most of all, the way they've just loved one another and included me in that. It's been a great privilege to be here. But the one other thing I want to mention before I close is I know I couldn't have done this without the full support of my incredible family. All my adult children have shared the vision for this school and contributed in so many different ways, from filming through to earth moving and planting trees and teaching. And it's a special joy to me that next year there'll be six of my grandchildren will be students at this school. That's special. And most of all, my wife Daphne has been an incredible support, a counsellor, at times a confidant, and at times someone who will say to me, no, that is a better way to do this. So her love and support has been amazing and invaluable. Here at Belgrave, we love stories and we love story-based learning. But the school itself is an amazing story. The only school in Australia I know of that was started by two mothers. And look what it's grown to be. All under God's smile. It should have stopped, it should have died, it should have been finished a long time ago. And God intervened and brought the school to life and to fullness. It's been a real privilege to be part of that. And it's an amazing story of grace and redemption by a good God. And it's been a great pleasure to be part of that. Thank you.
What a message. Thank you, Mr. Keller. You always have a way of bringing truth down to earth and making difficult concepts easy to understand.
We salute you and honour you and your huge investment to BHCS.
I'm not crying, guys. It's you guys that are crying.
Oh, we're sure going to miss you, Mr. Keller.
After what feels like a lifetime of school, our Year 12s have finally made it. This talented crew is about to step forth into the world and unleash their gifts.
And unleash their driving. Now, I don't know who made this rule, but the students here actually park off-site, and I think that person that made the rule should be congratulated, because I still get a little bit nervous when I'm walking down to Birdsland and I see them coming in their cars.
It's hard to believe we finally made it to this milestone, but I know there are great things in store for all of us.
A time-honoured tradition here at BHCS is a rose ceremony, where I'll perhaps give a rose to each graduating Year 12 student.
Today there's been a whopping 50 centimetres of snowfall in the Dandenong Ranges, which has begun to clear in the late afternoon. We're crossing now to our preps as they tell us in their sweetest voices who their rose is for.
This rose is for Dion Abasingi.
This rose is for Tom Adabaster.
This rose is for Jace Baker.
This rose is for Jay Bell.
This rose is for Lucius Bell.
This rose is for Joshua Black.
This rose is for George.
This rose is for Mitchin Campbell.
This rose is for Alicia Carvalho.
This rose is for Lily Cavavin.
This rose is for Lily Sebescu.
This rose is for Andy Siokin.
This rose is for Rachel Calhoun.
This rose is for Lauren Courtney.
This rose is for Jacob Kramer.
This rose is for Austin Cummins.
This rose is for Mitch Stamm.
This rose is for Sam Davis.
This rose is for Tiffany Deedon.
This rose is for Will Davis.
This rose is for Shayla Dyput.
This rose is for Bonnie Donnelly Arthur.
This rose is for Caitlin Donahue.
This rose is for Olivia Etherain.
This rose is for Lee Evans.
This rose is for Jonathan Ferrand.
This rose is for Emily Franchi.
This rose is for Sean Gloucester.
This rose is for Lily Greensill.
This rose is for Matt Gazzardi.
This rose is for Tana Arnie.
This rose is for Ashton Haffenroll.
This rose is for Nathan Hive.
This one rose is for Liam Hisms.
This rose is for Grace Hoban.
This is a rose for Tears Hoppin.
This rose is for Ben House.
This rose is for Kylie Humbert.
This rose is for Darcy Ivor.
This rose is for Hannah Jackson.
This rose is for Nick Jackson.
This is rose for Sian Tassel.
This rose is for Kyle Jelinek.
This rose is for Dylan Knight.
This rose is for John Kutros.
This rose is for Max Millar.
This rose is for Jabe Law.
This rose is for Connor Lyons.
This rose is for Brody McKenzie.
This rose is for Alexander
McCaffrey French.
This rose is for Melody Messenger.
This rose is for Jamie Meyer.
This rose is for Ishamin Wesley.
This rose is for Ruby Mutimer.
This rose is for Trinity Phillips.
This rose is for Jack Rattersteel.
This rose is for Charlie Wachemeyer.
This rose is for Eliza Roma.
This rose is for Sam Roma.
This rose is for Joel Rowley.
This rose is for
Talia Rubia.
This rose is for George Seisman.
This rose is for Lachlan Sessless.
This rose is for Rebecca Smith.
This rose is for Annika Steer.
This rose is for Jai Stevenson.
This rose is for Nora Samra.
This rose is for Alex Jutos.
This rose is for Hayley Vanderhoof.
This rose is for Jade Walton.
This rose is for Nissa Walton.
This rose is for Cordelia White.
This rose is for Renee Young.
Well, I don't know about you, but I thought that was a fantastic celebration. The perfect combination of a wonderful year and era at the HCS.
I think I ate too many snacks. Did you know that a
Come on, Mr. Tree Frog... Stay on task. Don't go anywhere quite yet. We have one last final surprise for you. Our talented drama team and crew have worked tirelessly to practice for The Little Mermaid.
Is that where Melody's gone? I heard she got a part in this production.
While we couldn't quite move ahead with a live production due to this year's restrictions, we are pleased and proud to present this live medley as our finale for tonight.
You know what? I'm still disappointed that I didn't get the part. You should have seen my audition tape, Sam. It was absolutely amazing.
Actually, I have a little secret for you, Mr. Booth.
What's that?
Mr. Davidson leaked your audition tape. Who wants to see it? Because I sure do. No. All the kids do.
Nah, I think... Look at the time, Sam. I don't think we've got time to do it right now.
Yes, I think you're right. The students have suffered enough this year. I tell you what, we'll stick in this last slides of the show and see why you didn't get a part and they did.
Thanks, everyone. We appreciate your presence with us in this celebration. May God bless you. And remember to act justly, walk humbly, and love mercy along with God this Christmas. Keep being awesome, guys. One, two, three, hit it!
Look at this stuff, isn't it neat? Wouldn't you think my collection's complete? Wouldn't you think I'm the girl who has everything? Look at this trove. Treasures untold, how many wonders can one cavern hold? Looking around here, you'd think, sure, she's got everything. I've got gadgets and gizmos aplenty. I've got who's its and what's its galore. You want thingamabobs? I got 20. But who cares? No big deal. I want more. I want to be where the people are. I want to see him dancing, walking around on those, what do you call them again? Oh, feet. Flipping your fins, you don't get too far. Legs are required for jumping, dancing, strolling along down a, what's that word again? Street. Up where they walk, up where they run, up where they stay all day in the sun. Wandering free, wish I could be.
Herself. Is she ill or insane? Is You mean Ariel? I'll say. She acts like she don't see me. She doesn't even speak. She treats me like sashimi left over from last week. You see her late at night tossing in a Russian bed. Oblivious as rocks. You should ride it off the tap. She lays there like a lox. As sure as dogfish bites, something's made her lose her head.
She has lost her head.
And she sighs as she swoons and just humming little shoes.
Even has a sort of glow.
What on earth could it be?
Any hammerhead can see that star, that glow, that
moon. Oh no, she's in love.
Shall we say?
Not good.
No.
Who will ease her woes and worries?
Who will help her get her man? Sweet child, perhaps the sea witch can.
You can't possibly mean Aunt Ursula.
She knows your dreams.
Father says her magic is evil.
She'll grant your prayer.
Please, I have to go.
'Cause she'll cast a charm.
A tiny spell.
Why the alarm?
No one will tell.
No one will care.
It's your affair.
Sweet child. Dear child.
Poor child.
Sad child.
We'll bring you to her lair right now.
Bet in half a sec
you're a prince and you are reconciled.
Together.
Forever.
Take me to her.
Sweet child. I admit that in the past I've been a nasty. They weren't kidding when they called me well a witch. But you'll find that nowadays I've mended all my ways. Repentance seen the light and made a switch. True, yes, and I fortunately know a little magic. It's a talent that I always have possessed. And yet lately, please don't laugh, I use it on behalf of the miserable, the lonely and depressed. Pathetic, poor, unfortunate souls in pain, in need. This one longing to be thinner, that one wants to get the girl. And do I help them? Yes, indeed. These poor, unfortunate souls, so sad, so true. They come flocking to my cauldron, crying spells, Ursula, please, and I help. Yes, I do. Now it's happened once or twice. Someone couldn't pay the price, and I'm afraid I had to rake them across the coals. Yes, I've had the odd complaint, from the whole I've been a saint to those poor unfortunate souls. Come on, you poor unfortunate souls. I'm a very busy woman and I haven't got all day. It won't cost much, just your voice. You poor unfortunate soul. It's sad, but true. If you want
want to cross the bridge, my sweet, you've got to pay the toll. Take a gulp and take a breath and go ahead and sign the scroll. Flotsam, jetsam, now I got her, boys. The boss is on a roll. You poor, unfortunate
about going up there. Now that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things surround you. What more is you looking for? Under the sea, under the sea, darling, it's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me. Up on the shore they work all day, out in the sun they slave away, while we devoting full time to floating under the sea. Down here all the fish is happy, as off through the waves they roll. The fish on the land ain't happy, the shark pulls the in their bowl. But fish in the bowl is lucky, they in for what's a bit. One day when the boss gets hungry, guess who's gonna be on the plate? Under the sea,
under the sea,
under the sea. Nobody beat us, fry us and eat us in fricassee. We what the land folks loves to cook, under the sea we're off the hook. We got no troubles, life is the bubbles under the sea. Under the sea. Since life is sweet here, we got the meat here naturally. Even the sturgeon and the ray, they get the urge and start to play. We got the spirit, you got to hear it under the sea. The lute play, the flute, the cop play, the hop, the place play, the bass, Sunday sounding shop, the bass play, the brass, the chub play, the tub, the flute is the duke of soul. The ray, he can play, the lilies on the strings, the trout rocking out, the blackfish, he sings, the smelt and the sprat, they know where it's at, and all that blowfish blow. Under the sea, under the sea, when the sardine in the bikini is music to me. What do they got? A lot of sand. We got a hot crustacean band. It's a little lamb here, know how to jam here under the sea. It's a little slug here, cutting a rug here under the sea. It's a little snail here, knows how to wheel it. That's why it's hotter under the water. Yeah, we in luck here, down in the up here under the sea.
La 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 la.
Les pois sont la poisson. How I love les poissons. Love to chop and to serve little fish. First I cut off their heads, then I pull out their bones. Ah mais oui, ça c'est toujours délicieux. Les poissons, with my cleaver I hack them in two. I pull out what's inside, and I serve it up fried. God, I love little fishes, don't you? Here's something for tempting the palate. Prepared in the classic technique. First you pound the fish flat with a mallet. Then you slash through the skin, give the belly a slice. Then you rub some salt in, cause that makes it taste nice.
Look at me, you see this face. In terms of beauty, I'm a basket case. And as for style and savoir faire, well, I guess there ain't. Oh, what there yet perhaps it makes no sense. I strut my stump with lots of confidence, 'cause though I lack an awful lot, there is one thing I got. I got positivity. I got positivity. It gives me the zam and the zow and the yada lada waddle. That's why I walk with the wiggle and the waddle, 'cause once you've heard that word, there ain't nothing you can do. So let that positivity work for you. Positivity, everyone needs a bit of positivity in their life. See, with the bim and the bap and the ba-ba-boo, you can flip any flap till your wish comes true. The tip is a tap into something that you believe. 'Cause with the zig and the zug and the ziz-a-z, there ain't nothing you can't be. You see, it's really your prerogative. You simply can't think negative. And now you know that word, there ain't nothing you can do. So go get some positivity. You can bet on positricity. And just let that positrinity. No, positricity? Who's atomity? Is it posit? What is it? Positively work for you.
A bad voice. Where's that?
If only you would notice how I ache behind my smile.
That
I guess
voice.
You never will. I guess it doesn't show. But if I never find a way to tell you so, oh, what I would give if only you.
We'll dedicate this last part to Mr. Kello, wishing you a very fond farewell.
If only I knew how I'd make him see the light. If only it were up to me, this all would turn out right. And if I only could, I'd tell you what I'd do. I'd simply wave goodbye and make your dreams come true. And wouldn't that surprise you if you only knew?
How could I have pushed her to the point of having no one left to turn to? What if I have lost her and it's all my fault? She's gone.
That voice. Where's that voice?
If only there were time, I know
what
kiss that
voice.
If I could turn back time, I'd change my
just
ways.
One more day for that
the
kiss.
Time keeps racing forward and our moment's almost past.
I'll try to understand.
It has to happen now.
I give my life up to make it happen.
I should have started listening to me.
How I wish that girl had